Now the third problem, which is based on the Thevenin's theorem, is find the current through the 10 ohm resistor. That means we have to find the current through this 10 ohm resistor, and we know through which we have to find the current. We are considering it is load resistor. The first step is calculation of the VTH. We are removing this load resistor 10 ohm with the terminal A and B, and between these two terminals all the network is same. Between these two terminals, we are considering it as VTH and finding the VTH. Terminal A we are considering plus, and the terminal B we are considering it as minus. See here, if the terminal A and B is open circuited, there is no current flowing through this loop, only the current flowing through this two loop. Likewise, suppose the current flowing through the first loop is I1 and the current flowing through the second loop is I2. As we know, in the KVL for the mesh analysis, we are using the sign conventions for solving the problem. So simply, the current in this loop is clockwise, and we are considering the sign conventions like this: starting terminal is plus, end terminal is minus, starting terminal plus, end terminal minus, then minus plus as it is. Then for the loop 2, for the current flowing like this from the 2 ohm resistor, so starting plus, end minus, plus minus plus minus. Now we are applying the KVL in the first loop. For finding, applying KVL in loop 1 for finding the current I1. So simply suppose we are starting from the 10 volt, current flowing like this, minus to plus, so simply it is rise in voltage, and we are considering it is plus 10. Then for the 6 ohm resistor, it is plus to minus, therefore it is minus 6 into I1. Now the current or a resistor 1 or through resistor 1, the current I1 and I both are flowing, but we are applying the KVL or loop equation for the loop 1, so we are subtracting the current I2 from the current I1 for the resistor 1 ohm. Now the current flowing from plus to minus, so minus 1 into I1 minus I2. Here we are doing the I1 minus I2 because we are considering the first loop is equal to 0. The final equation of this equation is save an I1 minus I2 is equal to 10. Suppose this is first equation. Now applying KVL in loop 2. See here, suppose we are starting from the 2 ohm resistor, so it is current flowing from plus to minus, so simply it is minus 2 into I2. Then through the 3 ohm resistor, plus to minus again, so minus 3 into I2. Then through the 1 ohm resistor, both the current I1 and I2 are flowing, but we are considering the second loop, so simply we are subtracting the I1 from the I2, so simply it is minus I2 minus I1 is equal to 0. By solving this equation, we get I1 minus 6 I2 is equal to 0. And see here, in this loop or finding the VTH, we need only the current flowing through the 3 ohm resistor, and the current flowing through the 3 ohm resistor is only I2. So through these two equations, first and the second, we are finding the values of I2. So simply by solving the equation 1 and 2, we get the value of I2 is 0.24 ampere. Now we are applying KVL in VTH loop. See, suppose I'm starting from the VTH, so current or direction which we considered for applying the KVL is from plus to minus or A to B, so simply it is minus, plus to minus, so minus VTH for the 20 volt, plus to minus, again it is minus 20. Then for the 3 ohm resistor, there is no sign conventions we have given in this loop because these two terminals are open circuited and no current will flow through this loop. So simply we are using the previous sign conventions of the current I2. So through this loop, if you consider the clockwise direction, it is minus to plus. So simply plus 3 into I2, because the current flowing through the 3 ohm resistor is I2 is equal to 0. Then we know the value of I2. By putting this value I2 here, we get VTH is equal to minus 19.28 volt. The meaning of minus sign is that the upper side which we consider for the voltage source in the network will be negative, like this. like this we have to consider in the network. Now the next step, we are replacing the network with the Thevenin equivalent circuit like this. See here, Thevenin resistance, so minus with the VTH is in series with RTH, again is in series with load resistance RL, and we have to find the current through this load resistor. This terminal is A and B. Now we know the value of VTH. Value of VTH is 19.28 volt. Here we are not considering the negative sign because we consider here the upper side is negative and the lower side is positive. Then the value of RTH, the step 2 is remaining, we have to find the RTH first. Now the step 2 is, we'll do it next. Step 2 is, calculation of RTH. Now for finding the RTH, we are replacing these two terminals with the RTH and other voltage sources and the current sources by their internal resistances. And we know the voltage source having the internal resistance is 0, so we are short circuiting simply. So 10 volt is short circuited, is in series with 6 ohm resistor, then here it is 1 ohm resistor, here it is 2 ohm resistor, then 3 ohm resistor, here the terminal A, then here the voltage source 20 volt is short circuited in the terminal B. In that we are finding the RTH. Now see here, the 6 and the 1 ohm resistor is in parallel, so 6 ohm is in parallel with 1 ohm, then this parallel combination will be in series with the 2 ohm. So simply parallel combination is in series with 2 ohm, so plus 2. Then we know this combination will be in parallel with the 3 ohm, so simply is in parallel with 3 ohm. This is the value of RTH. So simply it is equal to, by solving this we get RTH is equal to 1.47 ohm. Now here the value of RTH is 1.47 ohm and the RL is 10 ohm. So RL is equal to 10 ohm. Now the last step is, we are applying the KVL in this loop, and we know the equation for this. IL is equal to VTH upon RTH plus RL. By putting all these values, VTH is equal to 19.28 upon RTH is 1.47 plus RL is 10. So IL is equal to, we get 1.68. Is the final answer. And the direction of this current will be upward, because the current will be flowing like this, not downward. So current flowing through the load resistor will be upward. Ampere. This is the final answer.